Walrus and the Carpenter. Or the Story of the Curious Oysters. The sun was shining on the sea, shining with all its might. He did his very best to make the billows smooth and bright. And this was odd because it was the middle of the night. The walrus and the carpenter were walking close at hand. The beach was wide from side to side, but much too full of sand. Mr. Walrus, said the carpenter, my brain begins to perk. We'll sweep this clear in half a year, if you don't mind the work.
Work? The time has come,
the walrus said,
to talk of other things, of shoes and ships and sealing wax and cabbages and kings, and why the sea is boiling hot and whether pigs have wings. Kaloo, Kalay, no work today. With us. The day is warm and bright. A pleasant walk, a pleasant talk would be a sheer delight.
Yes, and should we get hungry on the way, we'll stop and have a bite. But Mother Oyster winked her eye and shook her heavy head. She knew too well this was no time to leave her oyster bed.
The sea's nice. Take my advice and stay right here,
Mum said.
Yes, yes, of course, of course. But, ha-ha, the time has come, my little friends, to talk of other things. Of shoes and ships and sealing wax, cabbages and kings, and why the sea is boiling hot, and whether pigs have wings. Ha-ha, Kaloo, Kalay, come run away, where the cabbages and the kings.
Some pepper and salt and vinegar, eh?
Oh, yes, a splendid idea. Very good indeed. Now, if you're ready, oysters, dear, we can begin the feed.
Feed?
Oh, yes. The time has come, my little friends, to talk of food and things.
Of peppercorns and mustard seed and other seasonings. We'll mix them all together in a sauce that's fit for kings. Kaloo Kalay, we'll eat today like cabbages and kings.
I weep for you. I deeply sympathize. For I've enjoyed your company, oh, much more than you realize.
Little oysters. Little oysters, but answer there came none. And this was scarcely odd, because they'd been eaten. Everyone.
The time has come.